Right then, good morning everybody. What I'm just going to show you just briefly is I'm going to sort my greenhouse out. I'm off this week from work, so I'm going to get a good sort out and I'm going to do a complete revamp and get it ready for planting, because I don't get a lot in it, it's just full of junk and everything. So this week I'm going to do it. I'll just show you the before and then I'll show you when it's all done and it's all plotted out. Junk. It's only a little 6x4 greenhouse, that's all it is. Junk in there, all junk, bags of sand, compost, pots. Them pots there, I'm going to try and do my own version of the quad grow, which I'll be doing this week. So I've got the pots, I've got some wood and I've got some trays, and I'm just going to try and see if I can do a cheaper version of the fantastic tomato planter, well, and chilli planter. So anyway, that's the greenhouse as it is at the moment. This is the other bit I'm doing. Under that blue thing there is my compost that I do. The compost bin. I'm going to be moving that to where that water button dustbin is. That's going there. So I'll be clearing all this out as well. So once that's done, I'll do another video and show you the results. See you later. Well, exciting times have come today in Scotland. The seed potatoes. We'll have a look at them. See what we've got. Nice and cracked. Okay, so the dean, which are the main crop. Sarpomera. You know, Sarpomera, all in good condition. First early is there, Pentland Javelin, maybe you can see that. Pentland Javelin. Second early, old favourite, Charlotte. What was that called sometimes? Charlotte, don't know why. And last but not least, the first ones that were going in, Swift, first early. All very good condition, very good seed potatoes, really happy with them. So I'll get myself set up in the greenhouse, and well, it's frost free, and I'll get them set up ready for chitting. Right, okay, here we are at the greenhouse. I sorted this greenhouse out over the last few days. I've shown you the before, and this is basically the after. Although there's a lot of stuff got to come out of here. I've still got stuff in the way. There is my trays. These are going to be my self-watering pots for tomatoes and cucumbers. Four along there as well. Hopefully. It's a bit of a take on the quad grow, so that I'll do a proper video for that at a later date. There's some there's a seed mix that I've made ready for planting some early leeks. This is the sand in there, ready for some carrots. I'm going to grow some indoor carrots as well as the outdoor carrots. Right, this is my little mini greenhouse within a greenhouse, with all my chitting potatoes. Now on this row I've got the sarpos. I've lined it with this stuff. It's insulation, wall insulation I think. I've just laid that on the bottom and that will help to reflect a little bit of light and a bit of heat. So we've got Swift, Pentland Javelin, they are Charlotte, Nadine, and of course the Sarpomera on the bottom there. See them there? These here are Rocket. These will be going in first because I got these last week from the garden centre. And as you can see, it's starting to get some nice chits there. Just there and there. So they'll be going in when they get a little bit bigger, probably beginning of next month, but it'll be in a pot. And I'll start muffing the greenhouse until it gets warmer, so I'll get some really, really early potatoes, hopefully. So that's just a quick view of the all the seed potatoes that's just arrived from Scotland, from Bridge End Garden Centre. Bit of advertising for them. I get them from there every year, always in good condition. So I'll sign off now, and back with my next video with an update. Thanks for watching. Right, hello everyone. I'm just going to show you a quick update on the garlic. This is some Solent white garlic that I put in on the 3rd of October. I've covered these over basically because the blackbirds keep pulling off the tops, so to give them a bit of a chance, I'm just putting these brilliant tops these off out of the strawberries and the grapes. Got holes in for ventilation. They're brilliant for protecting your plants, and then gives them a fighting chance. These are Marco garlic just here. Like I say, these are the Solent white. And if I just move the camera around, I'll just show you the elephant garlic. Now I've put bottles over these, just to give them that little bit of protection when it gets cold at night. But there's one elephant garlic in each one. They're coming on a treat. So, a little bit of a bottle, the lid off, gives them that little bit of extra protection. And I'll take the bottle off, and there's the other one. So I'm just growing two in these two pots that we're going spare, and that's doing absolutely fine. Okay, so I've got some more garlic over here, if I can spin it round to there. You can see that. Got some more garlic there that's growing. It's going on lovely. That was all planted at the same time. So just a little update on the garlic front, and I'll do another update in a few weeks' time. Let you know what the progress is. Thanks for watching. Bye. Well, what I did forget to say is if you're looking for where Tess is, my wife's in the house with an orange, and she's putting her priorities wrong, and she's staying in the house waiting for a bit of orange instead of coming out and helping me. So if you're wondering where Tess is, that's where she is. See you later.